Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to study about how to interface LEDs as well as the relay with PIC microcontroller. So first of all, we will start with the interfacing diagram which I have drawn into the Protease simulation model, Protease 8 simulation model. So just I will zoom this. So just I will describe the interfacing diagram, then we will go for the code explanation of the same. I have connected two switches, that is push button switch you can call. Initially it is getting 0, which is interfaced to RB0 and RB1 pin. These are the two switch. Then followed by the RB3 pin is connected to the one of the connections of the relay, whose second connection, the coil connection, is grounded. And here you can see the switch is normally open. Once the coil gets energized, then this switch will be placed at this position, that is normally open position, and it will become closed, and the sinusoidal supply which is provided, then it will glow that lamp. So we are going to I'm explaining about the connection interfacing diagram, and from RB4, RB5, RB6 and RB7 onwards I have connected 4 LEDs, D1, D2, D3 and D4 to the PIC 18F4520 model. So what we are going to do, I will explain that part into the program first. So one of the switch, if it is pressed, then we have to go for the right shifting of the LEDs, that is we are going to blink the LEDs towards the right side. It will start chasing from, that means this LED will be turned on, then this, then this, then this, likewise. So it will start chasing towards the right side, and if one of the another switch is pressed, then it should start chasing from left side. From the D4 will be glow first, that is it will flash first, then D3, D2, D1, and at the same time relay should be turned on, it will glow the lamp. So instead of this lamp and this sinusoidal supply, you can go for the buzzer or any of the electronic devices, as I have taken here lamp as well as the sinusoidal supply. So we will just go through the program. In the program I have mentioned it as a buzzer only. So first of all, we will start with hash include P18F4520.h instruction. This is nothing but the inclusion of the header file, then followed by the hash pragma. So this is the syntax in order to access the locations of the PROM, that is program ROM. Then in that I am going to access the configuration register, so that means config and the oscillator, that is high speed oscillator, power on, reset off, watchdog timer off, debugging off, and low voltage programming is off. These are the function prototypes. We are going to write two functions, that is for the right chasing of the LEDs and the left chasing of the LEDs. Initially I have declared some variables. So the switch which is interfaced to RB0 pin, I will call it as a switch 2. The switch which is interfaced to RB1, I will call it as a switch 1. Then followed by RB3 pin, I have interfaced relay. So I have defined this. These are the variable names and these are the pins. So instead of using this lengthy instruction into the program, I will just simply use the SW2, SW1. I will make those pins as 1 or 0. And then LEDs are interfaced to RB4, RB5, RB6 and RB7. So we will go into the white main routine. So first of all, ADCON1 register is equal to 0x0F. Its meaning is very straightforward. You should know the status of the structure of the ADCON1 register. So here, as PIC microcontroller has internal ADC, so that means it can have the channels from 8 to 14 and which belongs to the pins RA0 to RA7, but we want to use the RA0 to RA7 pins as a normal digital input output pins. So that's why we have loaded this with 0x0F value. For more details you can refer my website www.wikinote.org. then followed by, as we have to go for the structure of these two bits, that is these two switches, RB0 and RB1 pin should be input directed. So here in the code you can see we have set its direction as 1, so that means it will be used as an input pins. Then RB3, here relay is connected, RB4, RB5, RB6 and RB7, here LEDs are connected. So all relay and LEDs pin should be outward directed. So that's why TRISB bits dot TRISB bits, that particular bit has made 0, that means it will be used at output pins. Initially all LEDs are off. Condition related with switch, as here it has taken switch equal to 1 1, but as in the interfacing diagram you can see there is no connection between VCC and the pin directly, so it will, we will call it as a floating pins, neither 0 nor 1. So by default, if we are pressing the switch, then VCC will be provided and we will monitor the status of that switch. So here we will go into, and relay is also off, while 1 routine, if switch 2 equal to equal to 0 and switch 1 equal to equal to 1. So that means if switch 1 is pressed, if switch 1 is pressed, switch 1 is connected to RB1 pin. If this is pressed, so that means VCC will be provided to the RB1, and if VCC is provided, what we have to do, we have to turn on the relay by sending one value to the RB3 pin. So, and followed by, we have to call the write function. So relay is made 1, then followed by calling of the write function. So we will go into that routine where write is written. Yes, here it is, while write. So here initially all the LEDs are off, while switch 1 is not equal to 0. We know that switch 1 is 1, so that's why relay should be turned on. And the as discussed earlier, write tracing of the LEDs, D1 1, rest of the LEDs are off. Then D2 is made on, rest of the LEDs are off. Then D3 is made on, rest of the LEDs are off. D4 is made on, rest of the LEDs are off. So after execution of this routine, your instruction pointer will once again come from where it was called. So here it will come into this loop. Now if now switch 2 is equal to 1, then relay should be off and it will call the left function. So in the left function, what is done, what is written? So here relay is made 0, so that means relay should be turned off, and it will start chasing from now left side. D4 is 1, then D3 is 1, D2 is 1, D1 is 1. So that means LEDs connected to these pins D4, D3, D2, D1 will be turned on, and meanwhile the delay is called. So this is explanation of this code. So just I will burn this code into the controller. So I have already burned that code into the controller, just I will run that code. So see the working of this code. I will just start simulation. It should be properly visible. Okay, so this is below. Okay, so I'm going to turn on one of the switch. So if this switch is pressed, see left chasing of the LEDs. So that means this is switch 2, because in the routine we have seen if switch 2 is equal to 1, then LED should start chasing from left to right. Okay, after that I will press another switch 1, then I will release this switch. LED should start chasing from right to towards the right side, and see the change. The RB3 pin should be 1, so that means RB3 is 1. Relay coil will be energized, and this normally open switch has been become closed, and it will provide supply and the lamp will glow. If now see once again, if I am changing the switch position, if I am turning on switch 1, if I am providing 1, then relay will be turned off, as well as the chasing of LEDs will be from left side. See here, see LED off, lamp off, and LEDs has started chasing from left to right. If you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel, as well as do share this with your friends. And for the more details related with PIC 18F4520 and its notes, refer the website www.wikinote.org. Happy WikiNoting. Thank you.